Thank you. Greetings from the Avenue of the Oaks. I'd like to acknowledge President Kimbrough, the faculty and staff, everyone who is assembled here on today. By way of introduction, my name is Nicole Michelle Cooper Durio, and I am the 1996 Dillard University class valedictorian. I am pleased and honored to be with you on today. But to the class of 2021, and I'm not saying O-N-E, I'm saying W-O-N. Give yourselves a round of applause because you won. And not only would I like to acknowledge that you're all winners, I'd like to say welcome to your Ephesians 3:20 season. Now unto him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. Welcome to your path of abundance. Welcome to endless opportunities. Welcome to the bountiful favor of God upon your life. You are welcome, 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 class of 2021. At this time on the program, we'll now have the gathering. We've come this far by faith, by Sherando Lewis, class of 2021.
Thank you.
some, would everyone please stand for the call to worship with our call and response? We were down in the dark, now we glimpse a great light. What was nothing is turning to something. Terror tried us, storms denied us, racism tried to kill us, injustice angered us, apathy discouraged us. Oppression giving way to overflow. Burdens become blessing. Sadness to salvation. The yoke is broke. It's time to begin anew. You may be seated. Now we will have the invocation by Reverend B. Lance Eden, Dillard University, class of 2002, founding pastor of Blessings Beyond International Church.
Let us go to God in prayer. Most awesome and holy God, you have brought us to this season and moments of celebration for this class of 2021. Even in these unusual times, we fully understand that if it were not for you working all things together, somebody would not have been able to keep it together. And for that, God, we thank you. Let your spirit move through these hallowed oaks, that every heart would be filled with joy, every tongue resound your praise. Let every mind think and thank you for your goodness. With all humility, this moment was made for our hallelujahs. This moment was made for our glory to God. This moment was made for our thank you, Jesus, because you've been good. And for some student, they can declare today, through many dangers, toils, and snares, they have already come. In the gratefulness of this moment, where your word says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so, we have come to say something about how you've kept us and kept this class. And where the word of the Lord says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord, we have come just to do that with all that we have. And Lord, we truly declare that this is the day that you have made. We come to rejoice and be glad in it because, oh Lord, somebody is saying, yes, thank you, I made it. Move and have your way in our lives and in this moment as we resound, great is your faithfulness, oh God, and let us all say amen.
This time we'll have the hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness, Jolisa Singletary, Dillard University, class of 2006.
God, my Father, there is no
to share about this auspicious occasion, please welcome to the platform Dillard University President Dr. Walter Kimbrough.
Good evening. All right, come on, y'all. Good evening. Thank you. I received a text last night at 11:26 p.m. from Ja'Kiah Steinbrook, a junior who took my class, Hip Hop, Sex, Gender, and Ethical Behavior, this semester. In teaching this class, my goal is to transform my students so that they just don't ever listen to music uncritically, because lyrics provide opportunities for reflection and evaluation. Ja'Kiah wrote, "Although class is over, this dropped tonight. After a long hiatus, he's made a return. This would be great material for the next semester." She added a link to The Off Season by J. Cole. I was excited she began her text by saying, "Although class is over," because that means I have succeeded in my mission. But as a fan of Cole, having used a number of his songs and videos for class, I was excited to hear the new project. So this morning, as I started to get dressed, I began listening to The Off Season. The title alone speaks to me because I always look at the academic year as a season, and commencement then begins my off season. It's a time to allow my mind and body to recuperate from the grind of an academic year, this one more taxing than most due to the pandemic. But it's also a time for me to step up my intellectual and physical workouts to prepare for the next season or academic year. In fact, the week before our Faculty Staff Institute, I take off as my training camp week, highlighted by two-a-day workouts. Going into my 18th season as a president, this off-season is just as important as the first. The song, "Punching the Clock," featuring Damian Lillard, speaks to this when he says, "Summer is a time when you're preparing by training and conditioning so you're ready for the challenge." But the song I stopped to play several times is called "Let Go My Hand." Again, Cole speaks to me in the first few bars. He says, "Sometimes I question whether this stuff matters, putting substance into something in the world so used to instant gratification. Being present of anything is a tough job because sometimes folks you're trying to serve might appear to be ungrateful of the sacrifices you make. You question and ask yourself why, but at least in higher education, days like today provide a level of gratification because you can see the results." He goes on to say, "Things don't always connect as soon as you press play. At times you gotta step away, do some living. At times provide a new prescription, giving a truer vision. Fundraisers will tell you it takes time to move graduates from nausea to nostalgia, and Cole provides insight for your future. There will be experiences here with faculty as well as friends that you will look back on years later and find a new meaning. When people say college is not the real world, I used to think that they were crazy, but it's true. College is a bubble that breaks for you tomorrow. The only way you can delay it is by finding a new bubble to graduate into graduate or professional school, but that day too will end. Whenever that happens, I guarantee you'll reflect on something that happened on the Oaks and it'll have a new meaning." But the power in this song comes from these lines. "Today my son said, 'Dad, let go my hand,' reminding me one day he's gonna be his own man, and my job is to make sure he's equipped. I can see those times vividly when both Benjamin and Lydia would tell me to let go of their hand when they were toddlers, trying to assert their newfound independence that came as they mastered walking. Sure, I'd let go, but I'd follow closely by in case they stumbled or if they tried to walk too far. If we were near a street or busy intersection, I would hold on even tighter, even though they resisted, because I knew they had no concept of the danger a car posed at that age. Throughout your time at Dillard, you've told the faculty and staff to let go your hand. College was this newfound independence from your families, And here we are with these new rules, guidelines, and ways of being in order to prepare you for the real world. At times you tried to pull away, but we just held on tight, even when you threw tantrums on Twitter. Well, class of 2021, we're letting go of your hands. Time to be your own women, own men. Our job was to make sure you were equipped, and you are. But my prayer is that some of you will have an epiphany that having someone hold on to your hand is not always a bad thing. And I hope you will continue to grow the relationships with your Dillard mentors, because the songwriter Bill Withers was absolutely correct. We all need somebody to lean on. Cole's track ends with a prayer by Sean Puffy Combs. The song confirms a rumored physical confrontation between the two at the 2013 MTV Video Music Awards after party. Cole reflects on his own growth, indicated that he didn't know anything back then. He makes it plain, saying, ignorance is bliss, and innocence is just ignorance before it's introduced to currency and clips. Over time, I hope you too will experience such growth, repair broken relationships, and build new ones. My prayer for you is exactly what Puff prays at the end of the song. Lord, please guide our steps. Watch us, cover us, so that every move we make is in alignment with your will, your purpose. Please fill us with your spirit. Keep us forever in the present, for presence makes us the strongest fathers and mothers. Teach us how to leave, to lead. Show us how to love. Amen.
In order to be a bit more efficient and to spare my broken toe, please forgive me. Next we'll have music, The Lord is Blessing Me by the Vision Gospel Choir, followed by the reading from the Hebrew Bible, Justin Matthews, class of 2021, followed by a reading from the Gospel, Jadia Washington, class of 2021, then a reading from the Epistle, Makai Hayes, class of 2021.
greetings and salutations. If I haven't personally told you congratulations to everybody that's in DU21, congratulations. My name is Justin Matthews. I'm a graduating senior physics major, and I will be reading from the Hebrew Bible, taken from Proverbs chapter 1, beginning at verse 1 and going to verse 11 from the New American Standard Bible. Hear the reading of God's holy words. The Proverbs of Solomon, the son of David, king of Israel, to know wisdom and instruction, to discern the saying of understanding, to receive instruction in wise behavior, righteousness, justice, and equity, to give prudence to the naive, to the youth, knowledge, and discretion. A wise man will hear and increase in learning, and a man of understanding will acquire wise counsel. To understand a proverb and a figure, the words of the wise and their riddles. The fear of the Lord is beginning of knowledge. Fools despise wisdom and instruction. Hear, my son, your father's instructions, and do not forsake your mother's teaching. Indeed, they are graceful wreath to your head and ornaments about your neck. My son, if sinners entice you, do not consent. If they say, come with us, let us lie in the wait for blood. Let us ambush the innocent without cause. Thank you.
Good evening, class of 2021. Listen, y'all a little bit too quiet for me. I know this is a good auspicious occasion and these oaks are real beautiful, but the Lord did a whole lot for us to get here. And so I'm gonna need y'all to clap y'all hands like y'all happy about something today. My name is Jada Washington. I'm a criminal justice major from New Orleans, Louisiana. And today I'll be reading from Luke, the 22nd chapter, 31st verse, culminating to the 35th. Simon, behold, Satan has demanded permission to sift you like wheat, but I have prayed for you that your faith may not fail, and you, when once you have turned again, strengthen your brothers. And he said to him, Lord, with you I am ready to go both to prison and to death. And he said, I say to you, Peter, the rooster will not crow today until you have denied me three times. And he said to them, when I sent you out without money, belt, bag, and sandals, you did not lack anything, did you? And they said, no, nothing. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Good evening, class of 2021. Come on, put your hands together. If you know God did something in your life, put your hands together. Hello, my name is Makai Hayes. I am a graduating senior theater performance arts major. I'll be reading from the second epistle to Timothy, chapter 2, beginning at verses 1 through 7 and 15 from the New American Standard Bible. Hear the reading of God's holy word. You, therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. The things which you have heard from me in the presence of many witnesses, entrust these to the faithful men who will be able to teach others also. Suffer hardship with me as a good soldier of Christ Jesus. No soldier in active service entangles himself in the affairs of everyday life so that he may please the one who enlisted him as a soldier. Also, if anyone competes as an athlete, he does not win the prize unless the competes according to the rules. The hardworking farmer ought to be the first to receive his share of the crops. Be diligent to present yourself approved to God as a working man who does not need to be ashamed, accurately handling the word of truth. Thank you.
We will now have music, Rise Up by Sharonda Lewis, class of 2021.
Broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find a fighter, but I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out and move mountains. We gon' walk it out and move mountains. And I'll rise like today. I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. And I'll rise up high like the waves. I'll rise up in spite of the ache. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand. And quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe, and I know you feel like dying, but I promise we'll take the world to its feet and move mountains, bring it to its feet and move.
We will have the introduction of our speaker by Taylor Boys, class of 2021, followed by the musical selection, Total Praise, from Vision Quest Gospel Choir. And the next voice that you will hear will be that of Reverend Brisbane, Dillard University Chaplain and Director of Religious Life.
Good evening to the best class to walk these oaks. Yeah. I have the great task to introduce someone who I've gotten really close to this past year. So let's get to it. Reverend Herbert A. Brisbane III, an ordained elder in the United Methodist Church, serves as a chaplain at Dillard University, where he provides pastoral, spiritual, and grief counseling, as well as prayer for students, faculty, staff, administration, alumni, and friends of Dillard. An anointed vessel who was equipped to minister the empowering gospel of Jesus Christ to today, Reverend Brisbane has been led by his vision, mission, passion, and purpose to use his gifts and talents to fulfill his calling for the past 20 years. Reverend Brisbane acknowledged his call to ministry as a student at the Spartanburg Methodist College, and he went on to become an ordained minister. A true servant leader, Reverend Brisbane has had the privilege to serve on several boards and committees. He has served on the General Board of Higher Education, the Summit for Young Clergy and Shared Mission Focused on young People, and he has also served as the chair of the National Steering Committee and a member of the National United Methodist Collegiate Student Movement. Reverend Brisbane has been involved in several ministries such as Young Life Metro Atlanta, Young Life Urban Spartanburg, Boyhood to Manhood and Sister 2, and Wendy Gap. Reverend Brisbane loves teaching, preaching, and shepherding the people of God. As a part of the Asia 2000 Mission Tour, Reverend Brisbane served as a missionary in mainland China and Mongolia. Since 2004, he also provided servant hands as a missionary in South Africa and Zimbabwe. A proud member of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated, Reverend Brisbane also served as a chaplain for Delta Lambda Alumni Chapter in Baltimore, Maryland. A native of Bishopville, South Carolina, Reverend Brisbane is a product of the Lee County Public School System. Before earning his Master of Divinity in Theological Studies from Wesley Theological Seminary, Reverend Brisbane earned his bachelor's degree in religion and social work from Clark Atlanta University. He is the eldest son of Herbert Jr. and Azalee Brisbane.
Lord, I will.
God some praise. Come on and bless the God of your salvation. Come on and give the God of your strength, the one who enabled you to make it to 2021. Come on and give God the glory and the honor, because it was He who enabled you to be here on today. Amen. Come on and bless Him and honor Him. Amen, amen, and amen. Good evening to you all. I greet all of you in the joy of Jesus. To President Kimbrough and First Lady Dr. Kimbrough, to Dr. Page and all of the deans in the cabinet, to the faculty and staff, and to this great august body, class of 2021, come on and give God a hand clap of praise. Come on and honor the living God for allowing you to see this side of the Oaks. Amen. Let me begin by saying I consider it a great privilege to stand here before you on today to take part in such a unique and sacred moment on your journey at Dillard University. How many of you are glad to be on the other side? Ah, it only begins here. It's only the beginning. Amen. But one of the things that I thank God for is reminding us that God is the God that says, I began a good thing and I shall bring it to completion. The question is, are we willing to be a part of the journey? And so many of you have struggled along the way, but God has kept you. God has allowed your family to pray you through when you prayed yourself through. There were some nights you didn't know that you were going to make it, but you can stand up and come on and wave your hand or do something and say, I made it thus far, because there's somebody that didn't make it. And when we think about this pandemic season, guess what? Guess what? You are the one. You are the one that made it. And for that, I don't know about you, but I got to give God praise anyhow, because if it had not been for the God that I serve on my side, I couldn't be here today. Amen and amen. And so as the song has declared, amen, and amen is a sign of agreement. And for many of you, you had to be in some type of agreement if you wanted to get out of class. Guess what your agreement was? To complete the assignment. Come on now. Amen, somebody. If you wanted to get out of school, you had to pay that tuition. Amen, somebody. If you wanted to get out of school, there's some things you had to put at the forefront of who you are. And guess what? One of the things that I'm very mindful of is that God has a plan for all of us. And for some of you, you were wondering, when in the world, what is it going to end? And it went by just that quick. Can anybody testify to that? Amen. But one of the things that I promise you, you're going to wish sometime along the way, you're going to wish you were back walking down these oaks, because guess what? There's another world outside of this gate called 2601 Gentilly Boulevard. But one of the things that this place has prepared you for is for the call that God has over your life. And it's not necessarily about standing behind the pulpit, but it's about standing in the purpose and the passion that God has already ordained for each and every one of you. And as you move forward, you don't allow nothing to stop you, because God has already declared that you are the head and not the tail. God has already declared that you are the lender and not the borrower. God has already declared that you are victorious. And the question is, can you continue to walk it out and be the Dillard difference? But if I got any witnesses in the house that know that you are the Dillard difference, come on and give God some praise up in this camp on today. And as we continue, I don't want to belabor the hour, but if I were to say to you that class is over, would I get a praise? If I was to say to you that papers, the presentation, and the exams are over, would I get a praise? If I was to tell you that the requirements have been met, will I get a praise? Y'all kind of quiet on me. You ain't understand what I'm saying right now. But one of the things that I love about the God that I serve, over 2,000 years ago, He reminded us, He said on the cross, it is finished. Anybody can celebrate that it is finished. But I'm going to remind you of something. But He was reminding us that it's finished for you and for me, but there's still a work that you must do on the other side. Because there's some words that have been declared over your life, and there's some things that you must do in order to execute what God has declared. Because guess what? You didn't put in over 4 years of time of sweat and tears for nothing. Come on, somebody. Your mom and daddy didn't pray you through and work those crazy hours to make sure your tuition bill was covered. Come on, somebody. But they were there praying you through, and we're standing on the shoulders of our grandparents, our great-grandparents, our ancestors. And for many of you, you can testify that it could have been you with Freddie Gray. It could have been you with Sandra Bourne. It could have been you, but you're still here to live and to declare what God is doing in and through you.
So, beloved, on tonight, if you do nothing else, there is something that I want to challenge you and remind you. Yeah, you may have finished on this side, but a class has only begun. Because one of the things that you got to understand that God has something greater in store for you, and he just used this as a launching pad for you to go in and to give the devil the hell that he deserves. Because if you don't do it, guess what? He got somebody else that will. But there's something that he's ordained for you to do, and you got to understand nobody else can beat you at doing it but you. Nobody can beat you at being you but you. So if you would just pray with me. God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, thou who has brought us thus far on the way, thou who has by thy might led us into the light, keep us forever in the path, we pray. Lest our feet stray from this place, our God, where we met thee. It is me, O God, who comes in this hour, asking you, O God, to be glorified as I come to declare that which you have for your people on this hour. So, God, you be glorified, allow the devil to be horrified, and your people fortified as we move forward in that which you've declared for our lives. For we ask this in your most holy and sacred name that we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. As a teacher, as an instructor, as a spiritual guide, I've always started with the end in mind. As I prepared for class, I want to make sure my objectives and learning goals match are realistic. As I prepared the lesson plan, I always started with the test in mind, because once I was clear of my learning goals, I could better prepare the test and the lesson plans for the class. I would typically work backwards, as one of my mentors would teach, or my mentor teachers would tease me, but it seemed best for me, because I always wanted my students to succeed, because if I got a clear goal in mind, guess what? I don't have to worry about someone not meeting it, because if you set the bar high, guess what? As someone said, if you aim for the moon and you fall among the stars, you've done something. And some of you right now, you may not be graduating cum laude or summa cum laude, but you're graduating. Thank you, Lordy. Amen, somebody. But you did it, and don't allow anyone to stop you from moving, because at the end of the day, your degree reads the same thing as the next person. Amen. And understand, it's about you walking in the door and being the best you that God has already declared that you are to be, and beat yourself at being you, and knowing that nobody else can beat you but you as you move forward. And so when Jesus said, "It is finished," Reb, what do you really mean by that? It has everything to do with you. Jeremiah 1:5 reminds us, before you were formed in your mother's womb, God knew you. Before you were born, God set you apart. Before you were born, he appointed you as a prophet to the nation. Some of you have gone through hell and high water, but you made it. Some of you had faith crisis, but you made it. Some of you have lost loved ones and wondering, God, where have you been in the midst of it all? But you made it. You are still here to give God praise in the midst of the craziness. And if anything else, 2021, you survived a pandemic. Oh, I'm just going to wait a minute, because I don't think you understand what I'm talking about. God told Jeremiah, he said, in the midst of it all, he said, "For I knew the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future." In other words, God already knew that you were going to be in the place that you're in right now, because there's something special about you. There's something unique about you, because he called you to raise hell up out of here, because God placed heaven inside of you, so that when you go into your next purpose, your next place, God is going to allow you to be the measurement by which he's going to use in order to show that there's something different about you. Dillard prepared each of you for life beyond the MyDU classroom experience. As you enter into the world beyond 2601 Gentilly Boulevard, I need you to understand a few things. When you said amen, or when you agreed in praise, you were saying something there. You were not just saying amen or agreeing just to say it because it's the right thing to do. You are saying amen because you have embodied your living faith. In other words, you have incorporated the lessons learned. You have learned more than you have give yourself credit on today. It was more than just going to class. It was more than just being in over here in Straight Hall or Hartsville Camp. It was about being even in the cafeteria. There were lessons that were being learned even as you had conversations with your friends, with your frenemies, and with your lovemies. Come on, you know what I'm saying. In the midst of it all, there was something that was being learned, something that you were learning about yourself. It really wasn't about the other person. It was about you at that beginning. And so here we are. There are some lessons like you can do this thing. You can walk without mom and dad holding your hands, because some of you was fearful about coming to Dillard University for the first time, leaving home. But God reminded you and said, you can do all things through Christ. For somebody, you do know how to play chess. You were playing checkers for so long. It was easy to kind of maneuver it, but God gave you the mind or refined your mind to so that you are a better strategist than you give yourself credit. You don't understand what I'm saying. You are now moving with more intentionality. You are not a reactionary individual. You have become more strategic in how you protect your future. You've been very mindful as to where you go, because you realize every step you move now, every step you make is dependent upon where you're going. And so, God, I need to know what you have for me. Some of you have been enduring some sleepless nights because you were uncertain about your future. But when you begin to go back to some faith moments that your parents have instilled in you, you begin to connect like never before. And so you've learned how to appreciate the persons you have become, because you recognize that you are fearfully and wonderfully made in the image of God, because you wrestled coming in here with your self-image and your low self-esteem, but you're walking out of here with your head held high and with a whole new view of who you are and whose you are. Do I have any witnesses in the house on tonight? But what I really want to wrestle with on this moment, one of the things when I got hired and to come and to be the chaplain here at Dillard University that caught my attention, it was your motto. It says, ex fide fortis. In other words, you see it on everything branded with the emblem of Dillard University. One of the things that you can walk out of here on tonight, you can say that your faith has been tried. Can anybody testify there were some moments you didn't know if you were going to make it? You had to fake it until you make it. Come on now. But guess what? You ain't got to fake it no more, because it's yours. You've embodied it. You didn't allow the devil to take anything from you. You had to be like the gospel lesson when God was talking to Simon Peter. You don't know what I'm talking about, because see, Jesus was there. Jesus was telling him, Simon Peter was talking to him. Jesus said to him, Simon Peter, I need you to understand something. The devil desires to shift you as we, in other words, there's some things that the devil wanted to take from you. But guess what? How many of you know what God has given you? Nothing can take it away. Because some of you had gotten so discouraged that you wasn't going to graduate, but look at yourself, give yourself a pat on the back and say, I made it. I am one of the one who did. And so when we begin to look at our motto, it means strength through faith. Romans 12:3 reminds us, and it gives just a little snippet, if I can just lift up the B clause of it. It says, as God has distributed a measure of faith to each and every one of you, don't you allow no one to take your faith and destroy it. Because each and every one of you have what you need in order to move forward. If anything, walk away with a lesson learned. Stop comparing yourself to the left and to the right and start looking inwardly and allowing yourself to be the better person moving forward, and be anchored in the faith that God has already given you. Because the truth of the matter is, you should have been gone a long time ago, but baby, you are still here. And so just in Matthew, he read for our hearing the Old Testament lesson, the book of Proverbs, open with some parental directions. And how many of you can remember your first day on the campus of experiencing SOAR, and your mom and your dad, you all are then in turn going through all of the orientation and ending up in the chapel and then having to experience the parting ceremony. You remember those tears that they shed because they didn't want to let you go. But then some of y'all, they were pushing you in here anyway. But even in the midst of it all, there was something that shared with you. They encourage you. They remind you that you can make it. Don't you allow nothing to take your eyes off the prize, because you were clear about what God was placing inside of you, and you had to hold on to what they were sharing with you. If you go back and begin to look at the Proverbs, it's a lesson that was shared, but guess what? You all have lived it out. You have lived it out. And so you've got to think about this thing now. When you came here, you had an option to take the blue pill or the red pill. I'm a Matrix fiend. And so some of you can live in the world and be just as crazy as you want, or you can then in turn take the voice that will say, look, stay focused, enjoy yourself a little bit, but I'm going to do what I need to do to get up out of here. Amen, somebody. But in the midst of it all, you had to wrestle with your own faith development in the midst of all of dealing with academic hell. You know what I'm saying? And in the midst of it all, you had to push your way through the situation. But guess what? You got through it. If anybody can testify to somebody else, you can do that. And so as you prepare to journey to the other side of the oaks, because y'all waited all of this time to walk up the oaks and you were raising some kind of cane, sending out tweets to Dr. Kimbrough, how we gonna do graduation? You are here. But it comes with a responsibility. It comes with a responsibility. As you move forward, one of the things the epistle lesson talked about, Paul talking to Timothy and reminding him that there's something that you have a responsibility to do. As you prepare to go to the next level, you have a responsibility of now reaching back and pulling somebody else along, because you didn't get here by yourself. I don't know about you, but how many of you are glad to know that somebody is praying for you? If you go back and look in the Luke text, Jesus was telling Simon Peter, he said, don't you worry about it. The devil has a plan to take you out of here, but I'm praying that your faith will not fail you. And somebody was praying for you when you couldn't even pray for yourself, and you're still a living witness of grandmama and them praying for you, the ancestors that were over in Africa praying for you, and you are here today because somebody took the time to pray for you. But most importantly, I'm so glad that Jesus took the time to pray for me and for you so that we can be here to bear witness to what God has for us. If you don't do nothing else, because on this other side, guess what? Everything goes higher and higher. You got to really begin to apply what you learned here on the other side of the oaks. In other words, you're no longer a student as of tomorrow. You become alumni of Dillard University. In other words, you walk with a whole new authority, a whole new responsibility in order to walk in all integrity of what God has called you to be. Wherever you go, understand that God is with you, because there are going to be some moments just like here in your own personal valley. You got to understand that God has been with you every step of the way. In those moments when you were trying to figure out how in the world were you going to pass Dr. Otterumbo's class, come on somebody, but in the midst of it all, oh for grace, come on now. And for some of you, you may have gotten into some trouble and had to deal with, come on now, Dr. Bullitt and the whole, you know what I'm saying, but God gave you grace to get up out of here. That's something to give God praise in the midst of it all. Amen. And so some of you had to deal with Dr. Buckles. Lord have mercy. But in the midst of it all, he's, come on now, God got you through it, so you got your degree on tomorrow. But that's something to give God praise in the midst of it all. And so as I come to a close, I'm a good Methodist preacher, so I've learned not to be long-winded, but I just want to just encourage somebody. I'm reminded of the Apostle Paul's second letter to Timothy, as recorded in the New Testament. In 2 Timothy, Paul writes the letter to Timothy, his son in ministry. He has trained Timothy. He's mentored him, and now it's time of Timothy to take the responsibility of leadership. DU21, you have a responsibility of leadership like never before. It's more than just getting a degree. It's about how you then in turn allow your degree and your faith to make a difference. Because one of the things you got to understand who you are with in this season. Moving forward, it's going to require us to collaborate like never before. Know your network. Know who's in your class, because the thing that we do, we have a tendency to read a book just by reading the cover and not going into the chapters. Make sure you stay in communion with your fellow brothers and sisters beyond tomorrow, because I promise you, you're going to need them. I promise you, you're going to need them, and they're going to need you. You have whatever it takes in order to turn this world upside right. Go in the power that God has given you. Go in the power and the assurance of knowing that God is for you. Go in the moment of knowing that God would never leave you nor forsake you. There are going to be some rough times along the way. But you got to hold on to what you know to be true moving forward from this day forward. Now, I know it's supposed to be a celebratory time. It really is. But guess what? When the rubber meets the road, what kind of praise you got in the midst of that chaos? When you all by yourself, you don't have your classmates anymore to then in turn lean on. All you got is your faith. Ex fide fortis, strength through faith. Because there are going to be some times you won't have someone to call or run to their room anymore. And you're going to wish you were back here on these oaks. But hold on to what you have. Hold on to the God who never changed. The God that remains the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. Amen, amen, and amen. As you are there, I'm going to ask you just to place your hand in your own hand. Hold your hand, cup your hand. And as you're seated there, understand that's all that's going to be holding you sometimes. Understand that that's nobody but you and God. And be reminded that that's all you need in those moments when you're all by yourself. God, I thank you for the hand of the one that I'm holding and the life that it represents. And God, as they embark upon a new journey, remind them that there are going to be times when they may feel alone, but remind them that they're never alone, that everything that they need is already inside of them. And in those moments when it seems more that they can bear, remind them that they can go to the God that hears them when they're called. Remind them that they can look to the hills knowing that their help will truly come from God. And remind them that they are to be the difference that you've called them to be. Not comparing themselves to the left or to the right, but reminding themselves that they are to beat themselves day by day, that they are to be better the next day than they was yesterday. God, I give you thanks and give you praise for a fresh wind as they are empowered to go and turn the world right side up. Allow them to embrace their passion and to embrace their purpose as they embrace the positioning that you've ordained for their life. And God, in those moments when fear wants to overtake them, remind them you didn't give them a spirit of fear, but of love, peace, and a sound mind. Let them go in the victory of knowing that it is finished because your son said so over 2,000 years ago. But most importantly, you said that he's praying that their faith will not fail them. And so God, we hold true to your word. We give you the honor, and we give you the praise, for we pray this prayer in your most holy and sacred name. Amen, amen, and amen. Come on, if you believe it to be so, come on and give God some praise. Come on and honor the God of our salvation, for he alone is worthy. Amen and amen.
Thank you for that wonderful word, Reverend Brisbane. And so just a few announcements. Students, or graduates, don't forget that your call time tomorrow is 6:45 a.m. in Dent Hall. Be sure to check your emails one last time tonight because we will send an updated message to you. Be sure that you have shared your reservations with your guests for tomorrow. And please follow up with your guests to make sure that they have arrived by 7:30 p.m. in their seats because we'll bring you out at approximately 7:40 because we do have a pre-commencement presentation for you. Thank you. That concludes the announcements.
I want to offer to the class of 2021 two challenges. When I did my greetings, I said that I was the class valedictorian. That was not to impress you, but to impress upon you, it's important to pursue the path of being a one percenter. We're all graded in quartiles. The top, the second, the third, and the fourth. One percenters control 95% of the capital and the economic wealth of the world. One percenters make 85% of the decisions that impact us. We have to become ready and prepared to be a black face that's seen in the right place. America has 326 million people. 1% is 3.26 million people, which means everyone under the sound of my voice, I challenge you to pursue the path of becoming a one percenter. When you listen to the alma mater of Dillard, it says forever guide. That means when you leave this place will never leave you. As a one percenter, you will make the difference, but you have to have guiding compasses. So I want to share with you a few of my guiding compasses. One is, if someone tells you you cannot do it, it does not mean it can't be done. It only means you cannot do it with them. Your alignment is more important than your assignment. You have to associate yourself with the right people. And this one is very hard and difficult because some of you out there may be first generation college students, but never, ever take advice from someone you would not trade places with. The second challenge is to come back and refill the pot. I encourage the class of 2021, before you pack your bags and leave this campus, stop by the alumni office and leave a $21 check. If you can, leave $210. And for the class of 2021, I'm going to leave $2,100. You cannot ask people to do things you're not willing to do for yourself. Forever guide, alma mater. And with that, we'll transition to our alma mater. We ask that everyone please stand. And we welcome back Jolisa Singletary, class of 2006. The last voice you will hear for this program will be our benediction from Chaplain Herbert Brisbane.
Oh,
Class 2021, go in the grace of the God that called you in your mother's womb. Class 2021, go in the power of the God who empowers you. Class 2021, go in the one who purposed you by design. Don't let anyone beat you at being you, but you. Go in his love, go in his grace, and go in his power. Amen.